laws. You have a right to an attorney present when you're being questioned. If you don't have the money for an attorney, I'll do the crime for you. You understand?
Go down.
Caucasian male, approximately 6 feet 2, 185 pounds, code 4, attempted robbery on embankment, no ID, you'll know who he is when he gets there. Over.
New prisoners coming in. We need you guys. Come on.
Hey, I'm going out to dinner with my wife. Can you handle it?
Yeah, I'll take care of it.
Come on.
Can we speak to Detective Mays, please? This is Captain Greg out of jail.
Just a moment, please.
Yeah, this is Mays.
Detective Mays, I have a call for you. I'll put him through.
Detective Mays, this is Captain Greg Johns of jail. A couple of my guys picked up Cal Lewis, and I just thought you'd like to know about that. We're booking him in right now.
Oh, Kevin, that's great. Where's he at now? Okay, look, Kevin, I don't want to tell your business, but watch this guy like a hawk. He's a real nut. Yeah, I'll be over first thing in the morning.
We'll be looking for you. Bye-bye.
You don't look so tough.
Man, if you ain't gonna feed me, I'm gonna go pee.
Hey, shut up! Sit down. No one's talking to you.
All right, I'm done here. Let's go.
Let's go.
Man, I gotta go pee.
Take one down. I'll be down in a minute.
Hi, Mabel. Hi, it's Susan over here at the jail. Yeah, we're gonna need a better meal. Yeah, can you believe it? We've got that escape murderer here from the state pen. Yeah, I know. Yeah, see ya.
Thank you.
And that's the latest on the Middle East situation. And on the local front, we have the latest story from Scott.
Cal Lewis, the serial killer who had previously escaped from a maximum security prison, has been apprehended and is safely behind bars.
So I guess we can all rest a little easier knowing that. But first it's time for the weather with our own Deidre Hagen. Deidre?
Hi, I'm Deidre Hagen with your local and national forecast for today. Locally, we are experiencing clear blue skies with a high expected at 86. Winds are not too subtle at 20 miles per hour, but should die down by early this evening. Nationally, showers are peppering the Midwest while the heavier storms are hitting the Carolinas. And as you know, Hurricane Harold wreaked havoc on the Florida coast last week. Damage estimates are in the millions, but I'm told Hurricane Harold is now under control.
Thank you, Deidre. Well, I'm sorry to say that this is the last telecast of our wonderful weather girl, Deidre. She has completed her internship and is now ready to go on to better lands.
She'll be going to the state of Nevada, where she has a full-time position as a weather girl, and we wish her all the luck with her new job. Thanks, Deidre.
Thank you.
That's her up.
Susan, how much longer before those reports are done?
Captain, I should have these for you in just a few minutes.
Okay.
Hey, Captain! Captain,
what?
He's killed Toby! He's cut his throat!
Who? Who are you talking about?
Cal!
Who?
Cal! Cal Lewis said he's escaped again! He's gone!
Lewis escaped?
Shit.
Don't believe a word of it.
Oh, really?
She's a world-famous psychic.
Hello, Monique.
I'm so glad to meet you. I'm delighted. I've been a friend of your mother's for years. Now, there's so many nice things about you.
Oh, thank you.
Attention, everybody. I want to offer a toast to Deidre. She's done a wonderful job here, and we're all going to miss her. Let's wish her good luck.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Good luck, honey.
We missed
all. Are you excited? I'm so excited. We're having a cake.
Oh, thank you so much.
Have you given any thought to who's to replace Deidre in this position?
She's thinking of me. Because I've been doing this for a number of years, so I think when you make the decision, you go in your office, decide what you're going to do. Take a look at my resume. Look at it very closely.
You will make it very different.
We'll give you the resume.
I'd like to see your resume.
Oh, I'd be happy to give you a reading. You can just come over anytime. No charge.
Oh, that'd be great. I'd love to know what my future goals are going to be.
Oh, certainly. I'm sure you would.
Let's have a look at this book.
Well, I haven't quite decided that yet.
I'm available.
Good. So when do you leave?
Tomorrow.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I'll pack and ready to go?
I'll pack and ready to go.
That's wonderful.
I'm glad to see you.
Yeah, this is Mays.
I'm putting a call through. Yes, same source.
What? How long ago? What happened? Did you have him in a cell by himself? All right, look. I'll get over there as quick as I can. Okay, got everybody looking up.
Just in, I had previously announced the serial killer Cal Lewis had been apprehended and was safely behind bars.
He killed one of the prison guards and has escaped again. The station is asking anyone who has any information that may help lead to the capture or recapture of this person to please call our emergency number there on your screen.
Please, if you have any additional information, please call the number on your screen.
Good to see you. I'm glad you could come right in, my dear.
It's nice to see you again.
Oh, it's nice to see you too. I'm looking forward to the reading.
Oh my. Wow, some incredible paintings you have.
Oh, I'm glad you like them.
Are they yours?
Yes, they are. I'll tell you what, I'll show you my version of Mother Nature. Come right this way. is. See, now that's my version of Mother Nature. She's got a bolt of lightning in this hand. She only needs a bomb to hold it because she's all powerful, as we know.
And the lightning and the rain, and on the other hand is roses and sunshine. Mother Nature is everything. And that's the ocean of life rushing past. And the harp signifies love because Mother Nature is love. Everything in nature is loving. Don't you agree?
Fascinating concept.
Have a chair, my dear. I know you're anxious to get on with the reading, and so am I.
Yes, I'm actually quite excited about it. I've never done anything like this before, but I figured with my new career move that it'd be kind of interesting to see what my future holds for me.
Oh, me too. I know it's going to be wonderful and exciting. Now, I'm going to just have to concentrate so that I can see the future.
Okay. Is there anything you need me to do? Would you prefer that I just sit here, or am I supposed to be involved somehow?
Just relax, my dear. I wish I could tell you wonderful, beautiful things, but that's not what I see.
What do you mean?
What I see is dark and foreboding and dangerous and evil.
What are you telling me?
The danger involves you, my dear.
What danger?
Just let me tell you this, my dear. Be careful. And all that you do, be careful.
I need to know more. You can't just leave me hanging here like this.
I'll tell you what I'll do. This afternoon, I'll go into a deep trance, hoping I can see more and tell you more. I'm sorry I had to give you this news.
This is not exactly what I expected.
I'm sorry it wasn't.
I guess I better be coming now. Thank you for your time. I feel like I'm forgetting something.
You are, your power bar.
Thanks.
I want you to take this with you.
Pepper spray? Mom.
Keep it with you at all times. It might get you out of a tight spot.
It could also get me in a lot of trouble.
You never know.
For you, anything, Mom.
Okay? Be careful. Rest and call me every night. Well, all right. Love you. Please drive carefully. And don't speed.
Mom, you worry too much.
Make
I'll
sure you
fine.
Call me every night.
I'll be fine. I will call you every night, I
okay,
promise.
Baby. Okay. I love you.
I'll call you as soon as I get there.
Be careful.
I will,
Make
Mom.
Sure
you
call
worry
me.
Too much, okay? God, I'll be fine.
Be careful. I love you.
I'm just going on a road trip. I'll be fine. I love you, too, and I'll call you as soon as I get there.
Make sure you do.
I will.
Bye-bye.
I will. Bye.
I'll be ready in a few minutes.
Okay, honey. As soon as I get your dad fit, I'll make ours. place is ready, come and get it while it's still hot.
I'll be right in, hon.
What happened to you? Have an accident?
You got a phone?
I sure do. It's in the house.
Can I use it?
Sure, follow me in.
Bet you liked your other son better. You're a worthless, no good piece of garbage.
Mm-hmm.
Eva.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
Where am I going?
Can you tell Bob the lady?
Oh, no, he's fine. Well, actually, I'm going to Nevada. Where are you going?
To Disneyland.
You're going to Disneyland? Oh, how exciting. Where are you guys from?
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma. I lived in Tulsa for 2 years.
You got family in Nevada?
No, I don't have any family in Nevada. I'm going there for a job.
What kind of job?
Oh, I'm going to be a weather girl at a TV station down there. I interned in the south, and now I'm moving down west for a little move up, so I'm excited. Well, you guys enjoy yourself at Disneyland. Have fun.
Okay.
Will there be anything else? Oh, no, I'm fine. Thanks. Here's your tab. How are you folks doing?
We're just fine, thanks.
Hello.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, hi, honey. Where are you?
Oh, about 300-400 miles out of town.
I'm so glad you called. I sleep so much better at night not worrying about you all the time.
I know, Mom, but it's hard for me to get to a phone sometimes, so I can't always call you.
Call as often as you can. I just worry about you out there, all right?
I promise I will, as often as possible.
I love you.
I love you, too.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Mom.
Thank you.
Oh, my God. A triple? All right. Yeah, I'll catch the first flight out of camp. Then and get on his trip. Yeah, I think he's headed that way, too. Yeah, look, I'll take care of contacting the brother and the girl that testified to him. All right? Yeah, I'll let you know as soon as I get there. Yeah, all right. Bye. Yeah, this Ralph Lewis? Yeah, Ralph, this is Detective Mays down in Texas. I'm the one that arrested your brother. Yeah, how you doing? Ralph, your brother escaped. Yeah, early this morning. He's already committed a triple homicide. Yeah. And, Ralph, we think it's probably headed up your way. Yeah, that seems to be the direction he's headed. I'm flying out right away. I'll be on his trail up there. So, I just wanted to forewarn you, all right? If you hear from him, please call us and let us know, all right? Yeah. All right, yeah, just call the department here. Okay. Bye.
Ralph Lewis to see Dr. Angie.
Just a minute. Dr. A, there's a Mr. Ralph Lewis here to see you. Okay. Go right in.
Thank you. Dr. Angie?
Hello, Mr. Lewis. Nice to meet you. Why don't we sit over here?
All right.
You're Ralph Lewis, right?
Yes, I am.
What's the problem, Ralph?
My brother, Cal.
Your twin brother?
Yes, we're identical.
Yes, what happened?
He escaped from prison 2 days ago.
From maximum security prison?
Yes.
And you're scared?
I'm very worried, and I thought maybe you could help me figure out what he might do or what he's going to do.
So he'll probably come to you to look for help. That's what you're worried about? There's nothing much I can help with on that, Ralph. But he is your identical twin, right?
Yes, but remember the trial?
Yes, I do.
He said he would kill all of us, and I don't know what to do or where to go. I thought that you could maybe help me.
He was a pretty psychotic fellow at that time.
And he is psychotic. You must remember one thing.
What's that?
You're in just as much danger as I am.
I appreciate the warning, Ralph. But the only thing you can do is get in touch with the authorities and cooperate with them.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you for coming in. Nothing I can do about this one, Ralph. I appreciate your warning.
Okay.
Good luck on this.
Thank you for seeing me on such short notice.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
pick me up.
No trouble at all. Where are you headed to?
Just into the city.
I'm Bob. This is my wife, Marcia.
You know, the desert's beautiful country, but it can be real deadly.
I'll be there in a few hours.
All right, what's the damage?
Well, you need a new transmission. It's going to run
$1,200. $1,200?
Yeah.
I just spent $250 just to tow it here.
Well, towing's not my business.
I'm leaving now. All right, bye.
The car's barely worth $1,200.
Well, that's a decision you'll have to make one way or another. You can either repair it or leave it here with the rest of the junk I got around here, or
well, look, I don't
whatever
have,
you can do.
I don't have $1,200, but I'll tell you what I'll do. When I get into Vegas, I will wire you the money if you could just start working on it right now. I'll wire you the money. I'll leave my car here with my other things, and I'll come back in a few days.
You can leave it here, but when we get the money, then we'll start work on it.
Excuse me for interrupting, but how far is it to Las Vegas?
About 285 miles.
You're going to Vegas?
Yeah, I am. Why? Do you need a ride?
Well, I don't know. If I leave my car with you and wire you the money in a couple of days, will you fix it?
Yeah, we'll start on it as soon as we get the money.
Will it be safe here?
Be as safe as it be anyplace.
Because I've got all my stuff in the car I'm not going to be able to take with me.
Well, hurry up and get your things. I'll be happy to give you a ride.
All right, I'll just grab what I need and I'll leave my car with you.
Wait till we hear from you.
Go ahead, finish eating. I'll pay the check and pull the car around.
Okay. Bob, why don't you get us a couple candy bars for the road?
Listen, I'm going to stop in the powder room and we'll meet you outside, okay?
That'll be fine.
Guy gives me the creeps. I think you should just leave him.
I know. I was thinking the same thing.
Why did you pick him up? I told you not to pick
well,
him up.
He seemed okay at the time.
Okay, look. Why don't you just meet me around the side of the building? Pick me up there.
All right. I'll go get the car.
Okay.
Cal?
Hey, you weren't thinking of leaving without me now, were you?
Come on, Cal. You know I wouldn't do that.
You know, Marshall, we're just talking to Bob here. You two don't want to get rid of me now, do you?
Oh, Cal, you know we wouldn't leave you. Why don't you just get in the car and we'll go?
Yeah, come on, Cal. Let's go. Let's go.
How much longer do we have to wait here?
I thought you wanted to have some fun.
What do you mean, have some fun?
Well, don't you want to be with me?
I'm not in the mood, okay? I just want to get to Vegas.
Well, I am in the mood.
Look, I just want a ride, okay?
Well, you didn't think this ride was for free, did you?
Look, if you want, I'll pay you. I'll be happy to pay you, okay? Just please get me to Vegas.
No, I don't want your money. Look, I think you better just get out. There's the door.
Walk?
Well, there's a rest area a couple hundred yards back.
Oh, are you serious?
Yeah, get out. Get your crap and get out of here.
Oh, my God. I can't believe you're serious.
Close the door out.
This is just great. Great! I'm in the middle of nowhere. What the hell am I supposed to do now? No bones, no food, no water.
I gotta take a leak. You gotta take a leak. Now you gotta take a leak. Why couldn't you have gone at the restaurant with the rest of us?
You know, it's funny. The urge just didn't hit me.
Oh, now the urge hit you. What do you want me to do, Cal?
I want you to find a spot I can start taking a leak.
All right. We'll find a spot. When you see a spot, Cal, that's good enough for you, you just let me know and I'll pull over.
That'll work just fine, Bob. Relax, Fisher, relax. Just relax here. Just relax here. Oh, right up here. The rest area, how about that?
How about that? My lucky day.
Uh-huh.
Bob, is Marshall always so sensitive? Well, Marshall's a good kind of kid, but these kind of things tend to worry her.
You know, I'm just getting the feeling that she doesn't like me.
I'm just a little nervous, that's all.
What the hell are you doing?
Oh, just a little insurance. Come quick, Bob's in there.
Oh my God, oh my God, what's happened?
He's down here.
Oh.
Thank you.
car broke down and I'm kind of stranded here right now. I could really use a ride to Nevada if you happen to be going in that direction. I'd really appreciate it.
Well, I don't know. I'll have to see what my wife thinks about
it. What does she want?
She needs a ride.
I'm stuck here.
I don't know. We'll have to talk this over. Let us talk a minute. We'll be, get
all
back
right,
to
thank you. Thank you. I'd really appreciate it.
She's stranded. What do you think, dear?
We're not going to give her a ride. Not a chance. You don't know what she's got in that bag. You can't be too careful out in a place like this. We're not giving anybody a ride.
Sorry to bother you, but I need to get to Nevada, and I'm stranded here. If there's any way possible you could give me a ride?
I'll ask my husband.
Please, I need to get back. I'd really appreciate it. I've been out here all day.
This girl want a lift?
Yeah.
Well, let's give her a lift. She seems to be a nice girl.
Honey, I'm wearing diamonds. She saw the diamonds.
Well, I don't think this girl's going to hurt you, to take your diamonds. She seems like a nice girl.
Oh,
let's give her a lift.
No. A nice girl, what? You don't know? These girls are as vicious as some of these guys.
You can't trust, you don't trust anybody. I don't understand you.
I do not want to lose this.
So just,
you want me to lose this?
I don't think.
No way.
All right. So.
Please, come on. Let's just go. Go, go, go.
Okay.
Please, darling.
All right.
Need a lift?
No, I'm waiting for a friend, thanks.
Suit yourself.
You know what? I think I could use a lift after all.
All right, get in.
Broke down. Some guy picked me up, but then that didn't work out. No one would give me a ride at the rest area. I just had the worst time today. It's been absolutely awful.
You know, you gotta be real careful. You can't trust this anyway.
Yeah, I know.
I'm headed to Nevada myself, so.
Well, thanks for offering me a ride. I really appreciate it.
We're gonna have to stop up here and get a little gas.
Oh, that'd be great. Maybe I can get something to drink. I'm so dehydrated from walking.
So what's your name?
Deidre.
I'm Jeff.
Nice to meet you, Jeff.
Right up here, it looks like a lazy little town. That must be where the gas is.
Oh. It'd be nice. I'd like to get something to eat.
How long have you been on the road?
Well, I was traveling for several days when my car broke down, and I couldn't fix it. Well, I didn't have the money to get it fixed, but it's just been hell. I've had the worst day of my life.
to me a real mess here.
How long do you figure they've been dead?
I'd say about ballpark figure, I'd say about a few hours.
Have you called the coroner yet?
Yeah, coroner's on his way. He's on his way.
Yeah, Detective Bureau, please. Yeah, Captain Moore, please. Yeah, Captain Moore, this is John Mays. Yeah, I'm out at the scene now. Yeah, there's no doubt in my mind. It's got all the earmarks of Cal Lewis. Yeah, he's definitely on his way into Vegas. Look, I think it'd be a good idea if you put one of your plainclothes detectives on Dr. Angie. Yeah, he was one he threatened also. Also, I think you ought to have Miss Fiedler picked up, put in protective custody. Yeah, that's Cal's ex-girlfriend. Yeah, he's made threats toward both of them. There's no doubt he's on his way there to try to find him. Yeah, it's pretty well wiped up out here. Yeah, I'll contact you as soon as I get back in town. Okay.
When I get to Nevada, I'm going to ask for an advance at my new job so that I can get my car fixed and wire it down there and have the guy put in a new transmission. That's what's wrong with it.
You know, you should carry credit cards.
Yeah, but I've got some bad credit right now, so I didn't have a lot of money to get down here.
Well, I guess I'm not borrowing any money from you.
If I had some, I'd give you some for the ride, but I'm sorry I don't.
Report that escaped serial killer Cal Lewis may be in the area. He's considered dangerous and may be armed. The suspect is Caucasian, 6'2", thin, wiry, last seen with a beard. His victims have included at least three of report.
1240.
Thank you.
damn flat. I hope this car's got a spare.
Don't you know? It's your car, right?
It's a rental.
Okay. Sure.
You okay?
Fine.
I'm going to check the trunk. I'll be right back. Right rear. Why don't you get out and stretch your legs?
All right.
Hey! Where do you think you're going?
Stretch my legs.
I think you're going to stay right here and help me fix this flat tire.
Oh! Oh, you bitch! Oh.
die, you little bitch. The desert don't get you, I will.
I need a place to stay. No, Mom, I can't stay here. Just let me come and stay there for a couple weeks until they pick him back up. Please, Mom, I've got to get out of here, and I've got to get out tonight. Yes, I'm going to catch the next... Yes, Mom. Yes, I'll get... Yes, Mom. Thank you. Okay. Okay, thanks, Mom. I'll see you then. Bye.
Detective Smith from the Police Protective Program. You remember Carol Lewis?
Yes, I do, and I just spoke with my mother on the phone, and I'm taking the first flight out first thing in the morning. I'm going to stay with her for at least a couple of weeks.
I will see that you get there.
Oh, thank you so much.
Body. water?
Here's some water.
A little bit on her face. Cool. Mm. Griffin, help Chris. I'll stay here with her. Keep the water here. Hurry. We need to get her to a hospital. Hurry.
Checking out.
Yeah, room?
21.
21? Huh, you're clear.
Thanks.
Hey, what happened to your eyes?
Radiator steam blew up.
What are you doing for it?
Nothing.
Oh, man, I'd have that looked at if I were you. You know, there's a healthcare center right down the road about 3 or 4 miles. It's on the right.
Yeah?
I'd stop in and have it looked at.
You think they're open?
Yeah, 24 hours.
Thanks.
Yeah.
David, that's a nasty burn you have on your face. How did that happen?
Carburetor fire on my truck.
Oh, it looks almost like one of those pepper spray burns.
Am I going to be okay?
Yes, but we're going to have to irrigate your eye and your face, and we'll give you a shot of some cortisone and some tablets of Benadryl.
Can we get started?
You bet. I'll have the nurse come right in. Nurse, this is David Smith. He had a nasty burn to his face, and we irrigated his face and his eye. And we gave him a shot of cortisone 10 milligrams. Also, we gave him a prescription for Benadryl 25 milligrams QID for 3 days. Here's his chart.
All righty, I will take care of that. Meanwhile, here is a chart of a young white female that was brought in earlier. And she is now in room 2. She was found out in the desert. She was dehydrated. We have her stabilized right now, but you really need to take a look at her as soon as you can.
Okay, I could do that right now. And would you start some IVs for her?
Absolutely. And doctor, to be honest, if that young couple hadn't found her out in the desert, she probably wouldn't have made it. Excuse me. Can we have an IV starting in room 2? Room 2, please. Thank you. All right, let's get you settled up here. Get your prescription.
I'll pay cash.
All right, let me see how much you owe. Oh, 1 moment, please. Quick med. Oh, I'm sorry. If you're coming in at 6 o'clock, I won't be here. My relief will be coming in at 5 o'clock. Yes, you can speak to her. All righty. Have a good afternoon. Bye-bye. Okay, I'm sorry about that. Let's see. It will be $65. Okay, is this some cash? I can write you out a receipt.
I don't need a receipt.
Oh, okay. Would you like to set another appointment to see the doctor?
I'm on the road.
Oh, all right. Anything else you need?
No, thanks.
Okay.
Hello. Hello, Monique. I didn't hear from Deidre last night, nor the night before. She's been so good about calling me every night. I'm so worried.
Oh, my God. I've been worried sick about that child myself. I had a very negative reading for her. It was not good at all, and I warned her. I told her to be careful.
I'm so worried. I don't know what to do.
Oh, I know how you feel. I'm worried about her myself, like I told you, but I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll go into a deep trance and see if anything else comes to me, okay?
Please, please give me a call. I'll be waiting by the phone. I'm so worried. She's been so good about calling.
Yes, I will. I certainly will. Goodbye.
Hey,
Sorry I'm late.
Oh, it's 5 minutes, no big deal.
Anything I need to know about?
Yeah, there's a girl in room 2, a young couple found her out in the desert unconscious, but we have her stabilized now. She just needs a little bit of attention.
Okay.
All right, well, have a good evening.
Thanks, have fun.
Andrew speaking.
Dr. A, it's Cal Lewis.
What's the problem, Cal?
I really need to talk to you. I need to meet you.
Where are you now?
I can't tell you where I'm at. No way. I really got to meet you.
It would be better if you could come to the office, Cal.
You're the only one who knows how I am, Dr. A. I'm in big trouble. You're the only one who can help me. I don't want to keep on killing. You've got to meet me.
All right, Cal. I'll meet you in about 1 hour near the old therapy building.
The building where we first met?
Yes, Cal.
Okay.
Billy, I'm going to be at this address. Would you get the police and the paramedics there as soon as possible, please? It's an emergency.
Of course, Dr. A.
Thank you.
Dr. A.
Hello, Cal. How are you?
Good.
Let's go over in this building. Here, come on.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Are you the maintenance man here?
Yes, I am.
Were you working last night?
Yeah, and I've got a hell of a headache to prove it.
So you're the fellow that was attacked?
That's me.
Did you get a look at this guy?
No, he came up from behind.
You didn't see him hanging around here at all before when you pulled up?
No, I sure didn't.
Where's the main entrance at?
Go down the hallway to the left. That's the front door right there. Oh,
thanks.
Yes, sir. May I help you?
Young Detective John Mays. I spoke with Dr. Stone earlier about Miss Hagen. Is he available?
Yes, sir. I'll page him for you.
Thank you.
Dr. Stone? Dr. Stone to the front waiting area, please. Dr. Stone? I'm sure he'll be up in a moment.
Is it always this hot here?
I'm afraid so.
It's hotter here than it is in Texas. Did she bring any ID with her?
Oh, as a matter of fact, this purse was brought in with the things.
I tell you what, why don't you just hang on to it for now? Also, this bag was found by the state troopers.
Uh-huh.
You could just hang on to that for me if you could.
Okay, I'll be right here.
Okay. Dr. Stone?
Yes, I'm Dr. Stone.
Yeah, I'm Detective John Mays. I talked to you earlier.
Oh, yes,
Okay, how's our girl doing?
Oh, she's doing better. She's more stable.
When's she going to be able to travel?
In a couple of days.
A couple of days? Doctor, I can't waste 2 days waiting around here. How about tomorrow?
Well, that's possible.
Look, I'll check her into a hospital as soon as we get to Las Vegas. Doctor, I'll take full responsibility for her.
Well, that's very nice, but I have to take responsibility for her.
Can I see her?
Oh, yes, but she may not be awake.
Tegan, I want to show you a picture of a subject. I want you to tell me if it's the man that attacked you. Miss Hagen? Miss Hagen? Is it him, Miss Hagen?
Yes, it's him.
Miss Hagen, is everything okay?
Nurse, please. Miss Hagen, how did you happen to be with this subject?
At a rest stop.
What were you doing at a rest stop?
My car broke down. I had no way to get back.
How long were you with him?
An hour, 2 hours.
Did you tell him where you were going?
I don't know.
Now think. Did you tell him where you were going?
Yes. Yes, I think I did.
Did you tell him anything else at all, what you were going to do there?
I was frightened of him. He was creepy. But he was persistent. I told him about my new job.
Did you tell him what your new job was going to be?
I don't remember. It's very hazy.
Okay. As soon as I can get you released, I'm going to take you on into Vegas with me. You're going to have to stay with me. He's not going to give up until we get him, or he gets you.
Come in, Smitty.
Smitty here.
How'd you find, Smitty?
Yeah, I'm saying you can get here in time. Call the county. I'll wait.
Hello.
Ralph, it's Cal.
Cal? Where are you?
I'm in town.
What do you want with me? What can I do?
I need your help.
What do you need?
I need a car. I need some clothes, and I could really use some money.
Listen, Cal, I don't know if I can help you. Exactly where are you?
I'm at a hotel at 10th and Bourbon Street.
Listen, Cal. The best thing you can do for yourself and everyone else is just turn yourself in. I'm not turning myself in. I'm not going back to that hellhole. Listen, Cal. Bad things could happen to you if you don't.
Like what?
After all you've done, the police could shoot you on sight.
That's right, Ralph. You're just like our mom. You're no damn good. You never liked me. You never would help me. You and her, you both hated me. You're no good. But guess what? I'm gonna plant you right where she's planted. You got it.
Have you decided what you want for dinner yet?
You know, I'm really too nervous to eat anything right now. I think I'll just have a glass of orange juice or something.
You should have a little more than that.
I can't eat anything right now, okay? How long do we have to wait here?
Till we get a call from Cal.
You really think he's gonna call?
Sweetheart, there's not a doubt in my mind.
Can't take this
rain. He broke out of prison with one thing in mind, to kill three people. The doctor that testified against him, he's already killed her. The girlfriend and me. So far he's killed 9 people on his way out here, so he'd leave me a trail to follow. And now he's got one more to kill, and that's you. We're gonna wait here until we get a call. It's coming. Don't worry about it. Just be patient.
Patient? How can I be patient when someone's trying to kill me?
We don't have a whole lot of choice, Deidre. He's out there someplace with one thing in mind. And we're going to get him. I promise you.
A news update. While awaiting transfer to maximum security, convicted serial killer Cal Lewis escaped from authorities. Lewis is suspected in a series of additional murders over 3 states. Described by police as 6'2" and thin, Lewis is believed to be headed to this area. If you think you have seen this man, call 1-800-552-2929. The police hotline is on your screen, 1-800-552-2929. Lewis may be wearing a beard. Once again, Lewis is dangerous and may be armed. If you have information, please call the police hotline at 1-800-552-2929. In other news,
looking for a date, mister?
Yeah. How much?
$300 all night.
Well, that's a little steep.
$200 for 4 hours.
Oh, that's still a little steep.
About $100 for a quickie.
Oh, boy. I think I'm gonna cruise around.
You sure?
Yeah.
All right.
Hi there.
Hi.
How'd you like to make an easy $20 without even getting those knees dirty?
Are you talking kinky? I don't do anything kinky, especially for $20.
Nothing kinky. Easiest $20 you ever made. You're gonna love it.
I told you nothing kinky now.
Look, I just want you to make a phone call.
A phone call?
Just a call.
A call to who?
I'll tell you who to call. I'll tell you what to say.
Do you understand?
Okay.
Now let's go.
Police hotline.
Hello?
You know that guy that you're looking for on the news?
Do you know where he's at right now?
Well, he's at the Roosevelt Hotel, room 422.
Just a moment, please.
Bingo.
Yeah, this is Detective Bates. Did she leave her name? Okay. What was the room number again? Okay. Yeah, we'll be there in about 30 minutes. Okay, thank you. Okay. Look, I'm going to be gone for a while. You just stay here, keep the door locked, don't let anybody in.
No, I'm not staying here by myself. You have to take me with you.
I can't take you with me.
You have to take me with you. I can't stay here.
You're not going to be in any danger. Just keep the door locked. I shouldn't be gone that long.
I'll go crazy. I've got to take you with you. Please.
All this room, you stay right beside me, you understand?
Yeah.
We have no idea where he might be coming from. You ready?
Yep.
Let's do it. Detective John Mays.
How may I help you, sir? That room is registered to Mr. and Mrs. Sam Davis.
Sam Davis?
That's correct.
Which way is the room?
That
Ralph.
Go call 911. Lock her down. It's a man with a gun, armed suspect.
Right.
Not yet. He's got my gun. He's chasing a young girl. Come on, go! Go! Go!
Thank you.
It's okay, baby. It's okay. Big daddy. It's all over.
I think he's dead.
Better call the captain.
Let's get out. Been better. How about yourself? Did you get any sleep last night?
No. I feel awful.
Deidre, baby, it's over. You gotta put it behind you. You gotta get on with your life.
I know, I will. Don't worry.
I made arrangements with the department for you to keep this car until yours is repaired, okay?
This car?
That's right. Here's the keys. This is Captain Moore's card. When yours is repaired and you get it back, give him a call. He'll have somebody pick this one up.
Oh, John, I don't know what to say. Oh, it's been so wonderful. Let me grab my bag. I missed you.
Gotta go. Gotta catch a plane.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye. See you later.
You're going swimming. You're gonna let the fish eat you. Your bait. Your fish bait. Oh.